The fish is actually a Jungian archetypal image. It appears in every culture of all time, and it's always positive. It's never negative. The peoples of Mesopotamia believe that their queens and kings actually emerged from the water, as started out as fish and became their royals. The Egyptians and the Romans equated afterlife success with the presence with fish. And in Asia, the koi in particular are worshipped because of their incredible color and their individuality. And it's actually believed that as a fish, they're so proud of what they are that they're proud to be blue and yellow and pink and white and all these spotted colors, where most other animals all look very similar. Koi are so individual. They live incredibly long. The koi have lived 225 years documented. And I read this morning on the internet about a guy in France who caught an 80-pound koi in a stream, and he was holding it in his arm, and it was big as a dog.
What about the colors? Are you purposely kind of inventing your own genetic mutations?
Absolutely. I started out with a much narrower palette, and I just started gradually doing that, and at first I was a little adverse, and then secondly it began to lead me into new places. And then my wife would actually come into my studio and say, look, they're great looking, but they don't come that color. And we were in Coral Gables in Miami. We went in their backyard, and they had blue koi that come from Africa, and they had green koi, and my wife said to me, she said, they really do come that color. I didn't care. I was only interested in what I felt about the color as I was painting them. I'm not really trying to copy nature. I'm really trying to create a metaphor with nature. My hope is that the paintings have a joie de vivre of their own, and they exist in a sense that makes one reflect on nature without being sort of stuck on the topic. On the surface of the canvas, I've been putting a layer of gel medium. And then after I work it onto the surface, using sometimes combs and tools or my fingers, I work into the surface and I create a rhythmic pattern. And in each case, I sort of just start with mush and evolve. Once I get a thing that I kind of like, I stop, let it dry a couple of days, and then I silver leaf it or gold leaf it. The resulting process then, I pour resin over the top of that. And when that dries, I begin drawing the image, and I use the surface that's been sort of graffitoed in to be the inspiration point for the drawing of the forms that come out on top of it. As I layer the color on, I start in acrylic and then I move into oil paint. So as I start in acrylic, I lay another thin layer of resin over top and then another layer of color. And I get these marvelous translucencies where the light is actually sort of refracting and passing through the color at the same time. And then ultimately it sort of reflects off of the gold leaf or the silver leaf underneath. And it's kind of creating effects that remind me of stained glass or some kind of glass-like appearance. I just love the sense of it's like an atmosphere that the fish exist in. It's one with. What they have begun to give me is a kind of freedom to connect the figure and the ground and the process all in one place, and I'm actually sort of creating a synthetic painting that I think is almost an abstraction, but at the same time connected to an archetypal symbol. And in that sense, I feel like I'm really connecting through the fish to the grand body of my interest for the last 35 years.